Welcome back to the Canada Info channel. My name is Wolo. I live in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, and I love to talk about everything Canada. How are you doing? How is the week going? I know it's a beautiful new week, and I want to say just stay positive, stay encouraged, and everything will align for you. I like to be positive, yes. On this channel, I say positive things. Generally in life, I'm a positive person as well, so I want you to be positive. No matter what is going on, everything will turn out for your good. So that's my word of encouragement for this week. And I want to ask, have you subscribed? Have you given me the thumbs up? Have you, you know, scattered the like button? Okay, so if you were not in my live video on Saturday, if you didn't join me live on Saturday when I did the live with Marina, yes, you know Marina Esiri, she's a YouTuber based in Saskatchewan, and I did a live video with her on Saturday, and we shared a lot of information. For those of you heading to Saskatchewan, please watch the live, and also encourage you to subscribe to Marina's channel, and you get more information about living in Canada as well. So back to today's topic. Yeah, today is a very exciting day, and I'll be talking about a new immigration pathway, provincial nomination pathway. I actually announced it on the Instagram page, the Canada Info of Instagram page, but I said I'll provide more details on YouTube, and that's what YouTube is about, more details on the YouTube channel. So Newfoundland on the 18th of November announced a new provincial nomination pathway, and this pathway is very unique for a lot of reasons, which I'll explain to you. I'll show you the announcement that was made for this pathway. Number one, for those who plan to study in Newfoundland and Labrador, what you should target is target getting into the Memorial University, Newfoundland and Labrador. Now, they're actually trying to model what British Columbia, Ontario and Manitoba does when it comes to people who study master's degree and PhD degree in these provinces. I've done a video about that before, where I said if you're going to do master's degree and PhD degree in certain courses, you should target British Columbia and University of Manitoba. There are certain schools in British Columbia where you just do the courses, and after you graduate, you're eligible for a provincial nomination. You do not need a work experience or a job offer to apply for a provincial nomination. Same thing with Ontario as well, but it's strictly for only their PhD candidate. So for people who graduate with a PhD from any of the universities in Ontario, they're actually eligible for a direct provincial nomination from Ontario. The same thing applies to Manitoba as well. People who graduate from University of Manitoba in certain courses, masters and PhD as well, and if they take an internship in either Accelerate or I don't know whether it's Accelerate or Elevate or something, I think I'll put the details on the screen, you will see it. If they partake in any of the internships, they are eligible for provincial nomination directly without waiting for a job offer. Whereas some other provinces, they require that you must get a job offer first before you get a provincial nomination. This is actually specific to people who are matured, you know. You have lots of matured people who want to come to do their masters, do their PhD, and they might not be eligible for the express entry pool. So that's what you need to know first before you even start choosing schools. You know, not everybody is eligible for the Canadian experience class. Not everybody is eligible for express entry. The next best thing is a provincial nomination, and you need to choose a province where you can easily get a provincial nomination after graduation. So Newfoundland and Labrador is the latest in line to join this group of provinces that actually give provincial nominations to people who must have graduated from their university. That's the Memorial University in Newfoundland and Labrador. And if you don't know, it is actually one of the most affordable universities in Canada for international students. So secondly, this particular pathway, they have 13 occupations in demand, and it will be launching January 2nd, 2021. The target is to get like 2,500 permanent residents through this program. And they are going to favor more or less people who must have graduated from Memorial University, Newfoundland and Labrador. That's one. That's not the only people they will favor. That's one set of people they will favor. The second set of people are people whose occupations are on the 13 occupations in demand list. So, for example, Mr. A is a temporary resident in Ontario, and their occupation is in one of the 13 occupations in the band. They are eligible to put in their expression of interest for a Newfoundland and Labrador provincial nomination. So that's the second group of people that it favors, especially those who are already in Canada and they know that their occupations are on that list and they are finding it difficult getting a provincial nomination, maybe from Ontario. They can actually put in an expression of interest for Newfoundland and Labrador, and then they will get the provincial nomination from Newfoundland and Labrador. The third option is for people who are outside Canada. So if you're outside Canada and your occupation is also on that list, you can also put in your expression of interest and an employer can contact you and show interest of nominating you. Once the employer shows an interest in your profile, in their expression of interest, they will notify the Newfoundland and Labrador Immigration Office and then give you a provincial nomination. There's also an option for people who studied in Newfoundland and Labrador and maybe relocated out of Newfoundland and Labrador. Those people are also eligible to put in an expression of interest and they are likely to get a provincial nomination. So you see all this information I'm talking about on the screen of this channel. I'll also be leaving the link on the description box of this video. I want you to check the description box and read it for yourself and also get prepared. On the 2nd of January 2021, they'll be launching this priority provincial nomination program for people to apply. So it's just for a limited occupation, not for every occupation. You know, every province, they have their criteria. They look at what they need, what are the areas that they need people in. And if they see that there is demand for a certain group of people, those are the people they would say they need to give provincial nominations to. So if you're outside of Canada, just watch out. On the 2nd of July, you can put in your expression of interest if your occupation is on the list of occupations in demand in Newfoundland and Labrador. So that's the information I want to share, and I want to ask one question. Have you subscribed to this channel? Have you given me a thumbs up? Have you destroyed, don't destroy your phone, don't destroy your monitor, don't destroy your TV, but just give me the thumbs up. Thank you so much. And yeah, I'll see you in my next video. Have a beautiful week and stay blessed. Bye-bye.